Rotation, of course, we first need an object. Give it a different color. Not necessary to rotate, but this will make things a little more clear. Whenever an object is selected, you see the selection extents represented by the square surrounding an object. Click on it again, and you get in rotation mode, and you get the origin point in the center. If you rotate by dragging one of the corner handles, it will rotate around this center. If you move the rotation point, it will rotate, or better said, still rotate around the center. Rotation point. You can even move it outside of the object and it will still rotate around this origin point. If you want to place this origin point back, you can do it like this, but you'll never get it on the right position. Press the Ctrl key and it will click on either one of the center or corners or in the middle. Of course, you can rotate by dialog, transform, arrange, transform, rotation, or Alt plus F8. You can enter an angle, select the origin, press apply, the other way around, or leave original. And that's it. One too many deleted. So this is set up. Now we have the object in rotation mode. If we now go to arrange, transform, rotation, you will see there are no origin points available because you've set the origin point manually. And now you can rotate around that rotation point. This, of course, can also be done manually. Press the Ctrl key, select one of the corners. The Ctrl key is to restrict to 15 degree angles. Press once on the right mouse button to leave an original and select arrange, edit, repeat, or just press Ctrl R. Much quicker than with the dialog. Also, when you have more than one object selected, we still have a rotation point, just like with one object.